Ms. Ingrida Vosyliūtė, and I work at Vilnius University Faculty of Communication, which is a cooperating partner in DARIAH for the last 2 years. And I was kindly asked by my DARIAH colleagues to present all the DARIAH infrastructure today, so here I am. So moving to the point, what is DARIAH? The grand vision of DARIAH is to enhance and support digitally enabled research across the humanities and arts. And this aim is based on three core elements. This is developing and maintaining infrastructure, also supporting researchers, and facilitating long-term access to research data. The history of DARIAH started in 2006, when infrastructure was first mentioned in European Strategy Forum Research Infrastructure Roadmap. And later, DARIAH moved into preparatory phase, discussing the concept, how this infrastructure should look, and what steps should be taken in order to establish a successful and efficient infrastructure. And now DARIAH is in transition phase, and it moved forward establishing a legal European entity, which we call DARIAH ERIC. So now DARIAH submitted an application to the European Commission for DARIAH ERIC to be established. And we believe that this legal framework will facilitate the long-term sustainability of DARIAH. The current status of DARIAH ERIC is collecting all the signatures from members on the commitment letters. So now we are having 12 countries that said they committed to be a members and they will be a founding members of DARIAH. So for now we have 4 signatures, as you see below, and other signatures will be coming shortly. And after that, the application will be submitted to the European Commission for the review, and we hope it will be accepted. And for other countries that are not founding members, it means that these countries have some obstacles, usually on their national level, to join, to be founding members of DARIAH. But of course, there will be opportunity for them to join DARIAH in the future, and they hope for Lithuania too. After DARIAH ERIC will be established, a DARIAH organizational structure is proposed, and there are a few main blocks in this structure. So the governing body will be the General Assembly, which will be responsible for all the governing of the infrastructure. And also we strongly rely on National Coordinators Committee, which is responsible for coordinating national activities at the European level. And another block is Joint Research Committee, which is responsible for coordinating scientific activities within DARIAH, and also it works with the scientific board. Scientific board advises the Joint Research Committee. And you see in the middle board of directors, so it's the executive body in DARIAH, and with the consultation with senior management team, it works on executing the daily issues of DARIAH. And of course, the coordination office, which is responsible for all the communication within DARIAH and its partners. DARIAH also laid down its budgetary principles, and it was estimated that for infrastructure to be successful and efficient, we need about 4 million euro per year. And this contribution would be collected from DARIAH members, and it will be counted on GDP of countries, like it is proposed from the World Bank. And this contribution consists of two parts. The first part is cash, which is only 10% of the contribution for the necessary activities of infrastructure. And most of the contribution comes as in-kind contribution, meaning that countries can pin the projects that they have at the national levels to DARIA and say, this is the project we would like to contribute to your infrastructure. So these projects, these scientific activities, national scientific activities, will be coordinated through DARIA Virtual Competency Centers, or abbreviation VCC. And we have four VCCs so far. So the first one, VCC Infrastructure, is responsible for establishing a technological platform for arts and humanities research. The second VCC is where the researchers are all sharing their knowledge and expertise and tools that we have. And the third VCC is to facilitate all the scholarly content, all the research data, and the last VCC acts as interface with the key influencers within and in the arts of arts and humanities. I will provide just a few examples of these national activities, initiatives, and projects, successful ones. As, for example, Open Edition in France, which proposes an open platform for community for academic community publishing, or DANCE from the Netherlands, which was mentioned in the morning, moving to the successful opening open access, and could be. Other countries are contributing in different ways. For example, Ireland, which has a master program in digital humanities. And there are many ways how these countries can contribute. And of course, there are more projects and more initiatives running around DARIA. But DARIA doesn't rely only on national projects. We are thinking about wider collaboration strategy, and of course we are seeking this communication and collaboration with other projects and initiatives that run through Europe, and we hope we can benefit from these activities, and these activities can benefit from DARIA too. And now summarizing all my presentation and maybe providing the introductions for the further discussion, what are key elements for sustainable DARIA? So, of course, infrastructure has to have some kind of legal status and reliable partners, and the organizational structure and financial model must be established too. And, of course, importantly, there must be some scientific activities that it is carried out, and it could be pinned with national projects. And collaboration with other European projects and infrastructures also could lead to sustainable infrastructure. That's it shortly.
Okay.